Captain. Marcus, what up, Marcus?
What up, babe?
Hey, Victory.
Yo, Spade, what up, Cruddy?
Hey,
me some computers.
How you doing?
Walking around like
June said he gonna intro Rowdy Rebel to us, then we take it from there. We got a couple before you hop.
All right.
All right.
Yep.
So we gonna get our GS9 on for a couple minutes, y'all. We lit.
So I got to keep this. People are hitting. We done shot plenty. I should say sorry to my penny. She called me bro, they in the street shooting Jimmy. I'm running down in the groove.
That nigga shot Jim.
Double cars, wallah. Hey, think that I'm Tom Cruise. Boop the Bobby with that tools. R.I.P. my Pluto. He's still in Vegas with the bros.
B.O.B., what up, homie?
On the phone,
told the DM, get it good. Mr. Elbow, what up? Gucci Rock, you know.
Yo.
I just got a brand new
smart. What up, Red?
about to get started in a minute. When we get started, everybody got to go on mute.
Knowing them niggas. But mostly with industry family niggas.
Let me call you back as I'm on the call.
Mute your phone.
Please mute your mic. DJ Nitro on here. Woke up on the roof of DJ Heat, what up? Sweetness knows on here. What up, Sweetness?
Bobby bitch, and I'm shooting niggas left and right, and things never right. My little nigga keep the pepper tight and leave you dead on sight. Little nigga, we the flexing type, you feel like flexing night. Put a bullet in your head tonight, we dead tonight. Tell him that I need some head tonight, I got some dead
right. Just now, right now. Rowdy Rebel will be checking in a minute. We're going to keep the music flowing. Shout out to Interstate Snake, B.O.B. We out here personally. We warming it up for Rowdy Rebel right now. Aladdin, what up?
DJ Edgemo,
what up?
Yes, sir. It's Mr. Water Whip. We get it.
Leon, what up?
We out here, person. I'm on the road today. I'm on the road tomorrow. I'm on the road up today. I'm on the road up tomorrow. Got me some today, got me some tomorrow. Give me a roll today, tomorrow, all tomorrow. I'm on the road today, I'm on the road tomorrow. I'm on the road up tomorrow. Got me some today, got me some tomorrow. Today, tomorrow, autumn. I'm on a road today. I'm on a road tomorrow. Like a load of the car. I'm in the pain today.
What it do, dog? It's good.
I'm Tito.
Yeah. Can you hear me now?
I'm on the road today. I'm on the road tomorrow. I'm on the road today. I'm on the road tomorrow. Got me some today.
He's filling it nicely.
Okay.
Tomorrow, tomorrow.
Big Hooks, what up, Big Hooks?
Yeah. Stu Review, Love Mafia, the gang. The room is filling up crazy. We got a good quality room. DJs, artists, influencers, people from Jersey, Philly, DMV, NY. It's going down real heavy. You know what I'm saying? We about to welcome Rowdy Rebel, DS9, Epic Records to the building in a minute. And that computer's record Reds just played just went gold. That's a testament to the artist to never stop grinding. That record is like 5-6 years old, just went gold, still moving. You can always get hot, you know what I'm saying? Just keep grinding out there, you know what I'm saying? Reds, what you got for him next?
Oh man, hold on. I got some goodies. I got some goodies. Just something I've been personally liking right now.
Make sure everybody stay muted too. We gonna have a full room and we gonna make sure that we hear everything Rowdy got to say. You know what I'm saying?
Let me get this one off real quick. It's a favorite of mine right now.
That LA kind of cool.
Hey.
What up?
8,000 from the beat.
Bro, I'm serious.
Q to Q, what up? You made it.
Yeah, just in time, you feel me?
Almost missed it. Q, what up?
What up, what up, what up?
Super the DJ here.
Me and my favorite, he ain't taking off. Taking off, I ain't gonna bite, cause she was basic. Got cutters in the car, the clip, nutty, buddy, pop, pop. I've been going hard, it's gonna be hard for me to stop. I need to spin on with the block and have him dancing like the mop. Oh, don't need no auto can, I just want my to bop. Okay, don't rack, suck, rock, keep that gas, talk. What they mad for, they mad, they don't add up. Yeah, I need cab, bro, that bag, yeah, that bag up. Yeah, I get mad, look, they be like, yeah, suck. Okay, don't rack, suck, keep that gas. What they mad for? They mad, it don't add up. Nah, I need care, bro. Get that bag up. I get mad, bro. They be like, yeah, so. Okay, now do we have a problem? What's it going to a guy? What? They want to know what I'm doing, but just know I'm up to something. Money, money, money. All I'm thinking about is money. Bring the beat back in, black. I just mother's motherfucker.
Like I said, we got Rowdy Rebel coming up in minutes. Got him coming up. Let's get that sign going.
I try to make the next motherfucking scene up, man. So I can finish you up.
This will still go off in the club.
Yellow beats, holla at me.
And two me and some hot niggas. Like I told this, I see when I shot niggas. Like you seen them twerk.
Pretty girl, Tierra Lanisa.
And we keep the mind millies on my block, nigga. Hey. And my dick keep it on the beat and drop, niggas. And we be wildin', he some hot, nigga. Tones only get this.
We DJ from the couch, super.
Try to run
from the couch.
Get shot, nigga. Running through these checks till I pass out.
Pass out.
The shorty give me neck till I pass out.
Pass out.
I swear to God, all I do is...
Yeah,
how to maintain. Get that money back and spend it on the same thing. Shorty like the way that I ball out, ball out. I be getting money top fall out. You talking cash, dog, I go ball out. Shorty love the way that I flow out. Free busy to let all of my dogs out. Mama said no pussy cats inside my dog house. That's what got my daddy locked up in the dog pound. Free fan on up, let all of my dogs out. We gon' pull up in that like we cops on them. With them 16s, we gon' put some shots on them. I send a love dot, send a drop on them. She gon' call me up and I'ma stick the highs on them. Rhyme savage, that's what we are. Rhyme shooters, just a G-star. GS9, I go so hard. But GS, I'm a thug squad. This bitch up is a problem, we gon' go and ball.
Rowdy Rebel on here. What up, though?
Hey,
tell them niggas free me. Free Subway.
Free
Breezy.
Let's go, let's go.
Tell my niggas free me. Team, I don't care. Fuck with us and then we tweaking, ho. Tweaking, ho. Run up on that nigga, get the squeezing, ho. Squeezing, ho. Everybody gets a bullet hole, bullet holes. Niggas got me on my bully, yo, bully, yo. I'ma run up with that gun on him, gun on him. I'ma run up, go dumb on him, dumb on him. Niggas got me on that young shit, got me on that go dumb shit, got me on that go dumb shit, man. Trap money, motherfuckers, hot in the bitch. Hey, yo, pull up, I need some more game.
Yes, indeed. Rowdy Rebel on here. What up, though?
Yeah. Look, all of us. We need the big boys to come out.
Everybody, shoot your phones one time except for Rowdy and Reds. And of course, June. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Everybody, mute your phones so we can hear, make sure we hear everything Rowdy got to say. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely a pleasure and an honor to have you on. It's definitely
good to have you on.
Good to see you out, free, making moves, you know what I'm saying? How you feeling? You know,
I appreciate it, bro, man. Listen, I'm just chilling. I'm in the crib. I'm cooking some food right now. I'm just chilling, making music, man. You know, every time I come to the crib for work, man, I'm just chilling, bro.
Hey, man, listen, man. repping the BK, repping Brooklyn, you know what I'm saying? That's a rich hip-hop history, a rich lineage, a long line of hip-hop royalty coming out of Brooklyn. And it looks like, man, y'all picking up the torch and running right with it. You know what I'm saying? How you feel like coming out of BK? What was your, like, coming up in BK? What was your hip-hop influences, like, musically? Was you locked in with Big and Hov and everybody, all the Brooklyn Pioneers?
I was just so much into music, period. It didn't matter because I was able to give somebody more, give some more, like, more special privilege. Is all or put it like this more because they from Brooklyn. I'm just a person that I love music so much. Wherever it's hot, wherever it's fire at the time, and I rock with it if it got a good beat and it sounded good, if I bop with it for me. So when I was coming up and music was going on, of course, Hov was flaming on at the time. Cash Money was flaming on. I was on some real big of some lock shit, Rough Rider shit.
Yeah.
And I just liked the music at the time, like, coming up, you know, that was that. And then started getting to that baggy clothes, whatever, big jerseys, headbands, make this money, take this money. And it just started to keep going. It just started elevating, keep going more and more. It just started changing because at the end of the day, there's more people coming about. There's more artists coming about, and they got their own style. They got their own creativity. I mean, so then I'm just a fan of music, bro. So when I was coming up, whatever I was rocking with it, man. But I was also a big Cash Money fan at the time, too, so.
What was you, when did you start, like, doing music? Like,
let me ask you this. Hello?
So what?
I was saying.
So when I started doing music?
Yeah, when did you start doing music? Like, when did you start dropping bombs and doing your thing?
I'll be in the car with my pops and shit. Like, we be going to my basketball game, wherever we going. And, like, the radio be on, and I always be, like, rapping over the radio beats. Or sometimes, like, in my neighborhood, there's so much niggas that rap when I was coming up as a kid. So I see them rapping and be like, well, I know how to do that shit, too. Because, like, whatever I be seeing my age group of niggas do, I be like, well, I can do that same shit, for me? So I just started rapping at a young age. I say probably, like, around the junior high, I'm just playing with rap, playing with it, playing with it. And then I went on to high school. I'm still playing with it. And then it's like, niggas in my neighborhood that's really doing it. Like, yo, boy, you need to really rap. Like, yo, I get on the track because every time the cameras come out, you know, like, these are times around the come DVDs, smack DVDs. So every time the cameras come around, I'm just spitting, rapping. You feel me? They're like, yo, now you need to really take this shit seriously, boy. Like, go to the studio. So sometimes, like, my bros, I was rapping at the time, I saw Kamikaze Car, you feel me? Shah Mula. Fuzzy, all the niggas like that take me to the studio. I'm like, yo, bro, here, try something. At the time, I feel like, nah, I was whack. You feel me? The niggas was nice, but they like, yo, just keep going. And then after a while, I just like fell back a little bit. It's like I'm in school, but I fell back from school because I started to be OD in the streets. So now I'm out of school, I'm in the streets. I'm like even on some rap shit.
Right.
And then I got some rap shit after like the streets is like getting like on some shit. Like I feel like the streets is like. We got the streets in a frenzy, so I'm like, all right, it's boring now, whatever. So I'm like, rapping on some, like, out of the blue, out of this spit moment. I had some money in my pocket, and I just kept saying, all this money in my pocket, bitch, I'm lit. And one of my bros was like, I bought some Schmoney dance, now she on my dick. I'm like, well, that's fire. And I just kept with those lines. And then he like, yo, let's go to the studio. I went to the studio. I threw a hook on the verse. So I just had that. I played it for the block. Bobby heard it. He like, yo, let me throw a verse in there. He threw a verse in there. And then, like, ever since then, we just kept, like, but we've been in the studio before that a couple times, made a couple tracks. But, like, that was just still, again, on some playful shit.
Right.
After I put the Schmoney down, so Bobby threw a verse on it. And the streets gave us the love. I seen up there. Then we threw a video out. And then I definitely saw the love. It was like, I started getting something like, I'm about to start making music.
Yeah.
I like the feedback I get off it. I like how people play my music when they see me, like, oh, it's you? Like, I was loving it. It was excited to me. And then plus, I love just hearing my voice on the track, knowing that that's me and I can do that.
Right.
So,
word. When did you link up with Bobby? At what point did you link up with Bobby?
I knew Bobby since kindergarten. While I was in kindergarten, so me and his brother, was always hanging out. And then it got to a time where, like, I wasn't the neighborhood bully, but I was just, like, the neighborhood rough kid. Like, like I was, like, a little bit older, too, so I was, like, I fake, like, to throw my weight around. So, but, yeah, but, like, I always been my boy, so... But I moved a couple of times out of neighborhoods for me, but every time I moved, I was, like, going back to my neighborhood chilling. Mm-hmm. So one time I had moved to, like, Brownsville, and then it was, like, for a year or two, I ain't been over there. And then I moved again back to the 90s. Mm. So when I moved to the 90s, for me, around, like, junior high again, for me, we had linked back up. So, but it's not even really back up. Like, I always still used to see, bro. Like, for me, and I used to always go over there and shit. So now when I got in junior high now, I'm going back to school in my old neighborhood, where everybody, it's like that same bond again. So we get the same body law. So now it's like seventh grade, eighth grade. Or every time, like, shit passed on, like, it was over after that, like, with my brother. I was like, it's never like when we linked up, nigga. We linked up since we was kids. But music took me linked up on the music tip. We linked up on some shit like, I'll go to his crib. He'd be in the crib, you know, doing what he doing, getting to it for me. I would have to get to it. And he'd be in there too, like, while he getting to do what he's doing, instrumental ones, just for me. Wait until like, I even waste the time, just, you know, like, at the time, while they going on, he's just, you know, doing him. Like, he bugging and doing what he's doing, you feel me? Listening to music, so boom. One day we in there, he threw this beat on ASAP Rocky, ASAP Furby. This shit was called Ghetto Sympathy. We called it the Grimy Sympathy. So we had went and did that. So now when we had went and did that, we paid it for the hood. Then we had another song we paid it for the hood. But we had Fake Chilled after that for a little bit. So when we did the Schmoney Dance again, it was like, yo, y'all put together. Like, y'all really like, bro, like every time y'all touch a track together, y'all fire on it.
So, right.
Fuck it. Let's do it. So that came about for me. And Howie, yeah, after that, we just was on some music shit. Like, yo, bro, go to the studio, I'm coming with you. You're going to the studio, come with you. If I go to the studio, I'll do sign up. Like, I'm sending you signs. It's this sign.
Yeah.
So we just became, like, for me, back to back with it. Like, for me, Meth and Red. Like,
crazy still to this day. Reds, what was you saying? I know, Reds, you was about to add something too.
Oh, yeah. So you invented the term, the word shmoney?
Not me personally. I'll be lying if I tell you exactly which one of the bros started it. Cause it's like, I can tell you around the time when it came about, like when the Floyd was running around, like he just thought like the money team. We was going to the club one day and the bro, we was deep and we was like, one of the bros like, yeah, the money team in the building. Cause we used to always call ourselves Cash on Deck, COD, Cash on Deck, Cash on Deck, COD. So like, when we came around, he started saying that. We was like, or something like, yeah, the money team in the building, Cash on Deck, the money team in the building. And one of the bros was like, yeah, the Schmoney team, money team. Then everybody was like, yeah, the Schmoney team. Like, and it just was like, it kept going on for the next day. I was like, Schmoney team, Schmoney team. Yeah, no one on deck, Schmoney, Schmoney's here, Schmoney's here. And like, all the hot boys, hot shit, like, yo, all the hot, for me, there was also like, yeah, Schmoney, Cash on Deck is Schmoney. All right, well, all the hot boys are Schmurda now. So I'm like, oh, that's fire. All right, all the Cash on Deck niggas is Schmoney. You know, the hot boy niggas that's always on some hot boy shit, they on some Schmurda shit, fuck it. And then that's how we got about for me. So then just now came about because we started getting on some rapping shit. So, yo, bro, we got to distance ourselves from this, from the gang shit. And then out of like DOS Selected 9, that shit just came about fire because like we just all rap. At the time, it was like we fucking on. And it's like, it's always about nine of us that rap at the time. You feel me? And like, everything's a 9 to us. So it was like, all right, DOS Selected 9. That's how we gonna do this music shit. So like when we started pushing God Selected 9 as music shit, we were so much already in the streets. Everybody thought like, all right, just not some next, you feel me? Dangerous street niggas, but that's not even the case, you feel me?
Mm-hmm. Y'all was just clicked up on that music. I didn't even know God Selected 9, that's dope. I didn't even know that's what GS9 stood for.
Oh yeah.
Man. So let me ask you this. How y'all feel about, let me rephrase that. Not how y'all feel, but were y'all cool with, like, Pop Smoke and all the other Brooklyn rappers that, because at the time when y'all was, when y'all was down, like, you know, they came up or whatever, but were y'all cool with them prior to that? or did you even know those guys?
Like all the rules, you talking about?
Yeah.
All right, so put it like this, like where I'm from like the 90s. Where they from is like Canarsie, but that's still like all in one section. Although my neighborhood is that we in the middle of literally everything. We in the middle of Brownsville, East New York, Crown Heights, Star, Canarsie, Mill Basin, Flatbush, Canoli Island, we in the middle of it. We dead slap in the middle of all that shit. For me, everything surrounds us. For me, so now the floss is just our bros. For me, we all went to the same school and then for me, from kids that grew up. For me, so like Pop was young. For me, so if I was home at the time when Pop was home, I'm 29. Pop was what, 20? So I'd have been, when I was home, I was what, 23? Pop would have been like what, 12, 14, some shit?
Yeah.
So we probably would have bumped heads, for me? And if we did would have bumped heads, it would have been on some shit like, it was one of the times we bumped heads where it was a big gathering, for me? And we probably didn't get to chop it. I really meet him. Or if he probably didn't meet me, who knows, you for me? But I know, what I can remember is we talked on the phone. And when we talked on the phone, bro, it was like I knew him forever, for me. His spirit was good. His energy was great, for me. Like, I write, it's like, I felt it, even though I didn't really know him. I felt it. I felt it for my little brother. I felt it for certain people I talked to, like that was around. And like, I felt it in their pain, when their voice, when I talked to them. I was like, damn, bro, like, I feel how y'all feel, like, it's touching me, like, bro really meant that much, like, for me, so it's like, hell yeah, bro, that shit was crazy to me, so, well, that shit was, like, a big loss, like, that shit was, like, more than a loss for, like, music, bro, a loss for, like, bro, family, you know, when you finally find hope and faith in something, for it to be snatched away, bro. Like, so, like, that's the morning shit I be, like, damn it, aiming me. Like, for me, that's what I'll tell my family, everybody, bro. And now we have to focus up and make sure here our future, you know what I'm saying? Our future is important and what's coming behind us, you know? So, all right, bro.
Talk. That's
I feel like I'm not into
nah, well, you fret. Go ahead, Stu. Go ahead.
That's what the youth need to hear, you know what I'm saying? As far as GS9, the label is concerned too, we know about you, we know about Rowdy, we know about Bobby. Is there any more artists coming out that we don't know about that you could let us know about?
All right, so bad right now, Schmoney Records, you got Schmando, we about to pop off soon. For me, you got Jersey Giuliano, we soon pop off soon. For me, you got Nino Cash, we gonna pop off soon. For me, it got artists out here, Fatal John, the list goes on, but we gonna take our time with this. For me, we gonna build our platform and we gonna do what makes sense. For me, artists that need to be artists and who really got this craft, we really wanna work for it. At the end of the day, I ain't about to push no artists that don't want this more for themselves. You know what I'm saying? That don't show me that work effort that I gotta constantly be on it, but they bond for it. I gotta constantly want this more than you. No, I don't need that. I need somebody who's ready to show the world their potential, who know they got this, who got the confidence for me, and just have fun with this shit, because that's what this shit about, bro. Enjoy exactly. Life.
Yes. Know? So you fresh up the vacay. Welcome back.
Yes, Darcy. Yeah.
Let me ask you this. Since you've been home, what has been the craziest adjustment for you? What's that one thing that you like, oh, it's wild out here now?
Getting a debit card.
Wow.
Like, I got to do, like, so much to get my bank card. Like, I have my money.
It's
yeah.
Crazy.
It's
I can see that.
Granted, you I know can what I'm saying?
Gotta have a debit card nowadays. Having cash on you, it's like, man, ain't no point, really.
All you gonna do is spend, then now you spending. You can't even leave a paper trail to put the shit back to make sense of it. Everything deal with credit, man. You gotta have good credit. So, like, bro, it's crazy.
Yeah, but credit is important, though. It's important.
Oh, yeah, that shit important. I don't want to nothing. I want to spend all these people money, and I'd rather just pay a bill every month.
Yo,
before
we talk about the music real quick, I know there's a few ladies on here. I know the ladies has been tapping in with you. You know, what the what the rowdy love life looking like right now? You know what I'm saying? Like,
hey.
The rowdy love life hitting on, man. Is it open, free game? Is man, it locked down? What's
up? I love. I'm gonna tell you some real shit right now, bro. Schmoney is I need Schmoney, bro. Like, I'm not worried about none of these females out here. I got my baby girl. I'm good with it, you feel me? Like, I need Schmoney, bro. Like, you feel what I'm saying? Like, that's it. Like, I'm focused right now. Like, all that extra shit, I don't need none of me. Like, no bitches checking for me when I was locked. I'm trying to check for me now. You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You want to support my music, support what I got going on. You feel me? Understand? I don't disrespect no females, no ladies. I'm all for the black community. You feel what I'm saying?
So the ladies, he ain't worried about you right now. He trying to get to that Schmoney.
But support my music for me. Like, I'm a good friend.
Mm-hmm. Okay, come on.
As possibilities.
Now, speaking of the music,
you gotta give him faith.
Give him some hope.
Give him hope.
No, we was just speaking of music. We was talking about before you got on, man. That computers joint. Like, what? When you released that 5-6 years ago, that joint just going gold, man. The grind don't never stop, right?
I was crazy as I did a band with the whole, but they didn't give me my platform because I was locked up.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So, like, when I came home, they were going to present it to me, but I guess they wanted to wait with me and Bobby together, but I ain't going to get that chance even because I ain't get permission from my parole in time yet to even be around him, so.
Yeah, what's life like that? Like, you know, how can you move and, you move around and navigate your career with the legal attachment still? Like, is it
it's good and bad.
Yeah.
It's good and bad. And I say that to say that because, it's bad because, like, I can't really go see my boy when I want to go see him. It's bad because, like, it'll be, like, 7:30 and the day just getting started. It's just about to get lit. You got to go in the crib. Mm. Bad because, like, I used to like to smoke a lot, but I can't smoke no more. I can't drink. I just got to be OD on my P's and Q's, and it's, like, it sucks because, like, I did all this time for what? To feel like I'm still in trouble if I do the littlest thing for me, and I'm a grown-ass man for me.
Crazy.
Then it's good because at the end of the day, it keeps you on your P's and Q's, like I said. It makes you, it keeps you away from danger, you feel me? While something going on outside, you're in the crib, safe, you feel me? You ain't got to worry about too much, you feel me? It teaches you discipline, you feel what I'm saying? And then once, when you used to doing something for 30 days, 40 days, what that become?
Habit.
Becomes habit.
But habit, right?
Yep.
And once I become something, after a while, the habit become addiction, or that habit become something that you just used to doing. For me, so I'm just trying to like be disciplined myself right now to just abide by the stipulation I got, and just for me stay out the way so I can just better what I got going on. For me,
nah. How long you on?
I'm on parole for 5 years, unfortunately.
Can't smoke for 5 years.
Yeah. So I ain't smoked for 4 years so far.
So no doubt. I'm a smoker, so I feel your pain. I'm gonna put one up for you, man.
Alright, man. Put one in the air for me, player.
Gotcha.
Nah, I'm sure a couple more gold and platinum plaques, man, at them lawyer fees, a lawyer out there can handle that, get you off early, you know, early release from that or something. That's crazy, man. You know what I'm saying? They should just let you go. Let you be out. But you know how the system is they always trying to set you up to get you back in. So we definitely got your back, and, you know, Stu Review, the whole Stu Review Mafia, we you know what I'm saying? We definitely sending positive energy your way on that tip. And, you know, you got the new single out with Nav. It's called Jesse Owens. You know what I'm saying? I know you're ready to go. You're ready to move fast like Jesse Owens. But it seems like even though with the restrictions and stuff has still been moving pretty fast for you since you touched down and now that Bobby is home. So talk about the new single and what's coming next. And we're going to play that joint. I'm going to try and play the video, too, if we don't have technical difficulties.
Yo, Jesse Owens, man, featuring Nav, man. New singles on all platforms, all streaming everywhere, man. Hottest shit out right now. After that, I got some shit coming for y'all, man. It ain't going to lie. I'm like, it's somebody's direction I want to go, so I ain't going to really say the wrong thing. Just know that I got some shit coming for y'all, man. So, Jesse Owens featuring Nav, man. Hot shit. I mean, Jesse Owens featuring Nav, man. Go get that, man. I'm in the crib. They all on my body right now. They in the garage, though. I think I'm going somewhere. Like, I ain't going nowhere. Yeah, man. Go get that.
Drop that. Turn out to that. Hey, Reg, drop that joint real quick, because I don't even want to mess with the difficulties. Drop that Nav joint on the people one time so people get a little feel what's going on in case they haven't heard already.
Turn off right now. Turn off.
Yo, Nav, what's up, bro? Got your minds over, don't focus. Please don't start no commotion. That plan, we up, we throw it. Ain't gotta think twice, I'm blowing. Me and that with a bitch and they get to the cash with my money grow. I didn't touch down and I ran up a bag so fast, I guess it's frozen. Straight to the top where we going. I'm fresh as the cannon, busting up. That's why I'm moving in slow motion.
Cover their mouth. They're gonna talk big. They're gonna judge where they walk. Run up that Schmoney with Shane.
We getting that performance.
Yeah, we got. Yeah, listen, man. I'm ready to go crazy.
How you hook up with How you hook up with Nav and them and the whole XO crew?
Slow.
Slow CEO. Slow Bucks.
Yeah, big bro, slow.
We got a lot of. We got a lot of DJs on here, you know what I'm saying, from all over, mainly from the DMV area, DC, Maryland, and Virginia. Any of my DJs want to chime in and holler at Rowdy real quick? DJ Flo, DJ Heat, DJ Reese, Super, where y'all at?
Yeah. Chops.
And we running that Jesse Owens on WPGC 95.5,
the DNA of the I'm saying the wild water true.
Absolutely.
Why are you telling me that for?
I'm just I'm
just supposed to do. It's fucking corny niggas out here on the fucking radio all day.
No, we make sure
niggas that love y'all too. That got genuine love of y'all too. Fuck you think? Niggas don't care. Niggas don't want to do Zooms. Niggas is bozos. Niggas is cowards. They don't want to do this shit. They feel like they ain't doing nothing.
Mm-hmm. They ain't lying.
I'm just letting you know. We love the record.
Yeah, I love y'all too. Yeah. I love the record. Fuck.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Rowdy.
I always put my ass on the record, but it only took a nigga like 15 minutes.
What the?
What's up?
That last joint was crazy.
Rowdy, you on Clubhouse?
Yeah, I got a Clubhouse. I've been on that shit like twice since I've been home.
I know that shit getting back.
Nice. To me. Yeah, that shit too mixy for me, I don't like that shit. Like, for me, like, it just, everybody can just, like, you can't just talk to me.
Word. Yo, nah, that's what
you gotta watch his moves, shit.
Yeah.
What's up with the album? So, Jesse Owens, you know what I'm saying? You got the other joint with Flex. You doing something with Funkmaster Flex, too? A project with him? Or what's going on? Project?
I just had to get us on the flights. Jesse Owens, like, my first official single. I'm about to drop again. I'm just deciding which song I'm going to go with because it's, like, three songs. We all decided on which one we're going to go with after three songs. Everybody got their opinions on each three, so we just want to, like, have one more sit down and just, after 20, just pick for me, go with the, for me, because, like, we want to make it make sense, you feel me? And, like, I feel like this time, this record right here, I want to show niggas a different side of me that come out for me, but it's still, like, Rowdy. It's just, it's Rowdy, but it's, like, a militant Rowdy instead of a rally that's just gonna jump up the cons, just throw the crowd out. It's a crowd out. It's not a crowd out rally. This a lay on your crib rally.
Word.
And calmly wait for me to take my pit. Did I make a little sense with it? Just not how I explained that. Like, that got what I was saying?
Nah, definitely. It's the militant discipline rally, not the wild out, okay. Just wild rally.
But let me talk. I'm going to talk to them on this one.
Nah, definitely. You know what I'm saying? And what's up with Bobby? Any joints, new joints coming with you and Bobby? Can you give us any, let any cat out the bag as far as Bobby is concerned when he dropping something?
Nah, see, like, we still got to get that permission to be around each other. So, like, we be on phones for me or, like, do third party when we can for me. We're still busy at the time for me. But like when we get the permission to fully be around each other 24, like, or we get that green light and just be like, all right, we can lock it for an album or we can lock it just, oh, it's go time. Mm-hmm. Like, it's the,
you know the world, you know, waiting for it.
Yeah, we waiting for it. You feel me? Like, I understand the world waiting for it, and like I'm so much thankful that I got people that love us and that just want some music. And that's just, you feel me, like our energy. Like, I'm so thankful for that, bro. You understand? For me, but nobody wants this more than me and him, bro. Like to us, like, we know, like we had it and we lost it. So now to have it again is like, yo, bro, it's like, we so in our mind, like bro, so focused right now. It's like jewelry, all that little shit don't mean nothing to him right now. He's so focused where, like, he can't even sit down and make his music right now because he want to make sure his future is secure. He want to make sure anybody that's going to be around him is on the same page as he on, or you can't be around him because at the end of the day, like, you can't fuck up what he got going on to make sure y'all good. You know what I'm saying? So, like, the page he's on right now is like, he need everybody to be on that same page. So once he get everything around him right and make sure himself is right and make sure everything around him is right, then he could go full force for motion. I feel like as fans, as supporters, and if you understand where we came from, what we're going through, and they got really rock with us, and y'all really understand what we're going through, then I feel like he deserved that patience, that he deserved that time. He deserved y'all to give him a little patience. He deserved y'all to hang in it with him for me, ride it out with him, whatever direction he decided to go for me. Because at the end of the day, like, he could have been home for y'all, you feel me? And he did something where a lot of people wouldn't do, bro. And he did something where he had a man up, step aside, so a nigga like me, bro, could have another chance to see my father, to see my little I mean, to even walk these streets, for me, hear and think about music, fans, and think about all that, not on some selfish shit, but on some like, all right, it's bigger than music right now. It's bigger than what everybody else wants. It's more so, I'm looking at my brother's face, and I could fix this problem, for me, and that's what he did, for me. So I asked y'all to bear with him, understand he went through a lot of weight. He made a lot of sacrifices, you know what I'm saying? So right now, it's like, even to me, I'm letting him get his space, you feel me? I want him to really have his mindset right, you feel me? And whatever he need right now, whatever he say right now, I give it to him. Whatever he tell the bros to do, the bros gotta give him that space. Whatever he tell his manager or whatever that's want him to do, just do it, you feel me?
Well, that's big.
Let him get back in. Right.
I want to shout out your bro, Fetty Luciano, too. I was connected with him while you was away. He was doing this thing with Def Jam, and he was out really holding y'all down, holding the whole family down big time. You know what I'm saying?
Listen, man, let me tell you about that kid right there, man. For me, because, like, that kid is special, bro. I'm talking about, if I cut my hair tomorrow, he's cutting his hair.
Word.
You know what I'm saying? Like, when I grew my hair, he grew his hair. When I started playing basketball, he started playing basketball. Like, he didn't know how to do it. He didn't rap. He stayed with me all the time. He didn't know how to rap. He didn't know how to flow to a beat. He didn't know how to put words to a beat and keep it going.
That's crazy.
I say he's special because when we got locked up, he had to adapt. He was 19 when he went to jail. Kid was a star as a basketball team. He was like one of the stars. Like, promised the future and had that for me. He gets locked up in a gang of dangling with us. For me, pictures, long time with something, just the bros couldn't hold it. You know what I'm saying? One pitch, one time, group of poverty, what he used to, for me. Scratch that. He locked up now. Wherever you at in life, if you want to be there for over a period of time, you're going to have to learn to adapt it. For me, no matter what, you're going to have to learn to adapt to your surroundings. Don't keep you there for 5 minutes. Observe, see what's going on, patience. So I say that to say this. My boy came out as a champ. He came out as a man. He came out focused with a plan. Yo, bro, listen, bro, I understand I have as much people on my Instagram that's going to be at this. Fans, listen, I have to start this time when I come home. I'm going to do this. Blah. I'm on this music shit, bro. I'm like, music? You doing what? I'm like, yeah, music shit. I'm like, what you mean? What you gonna do? Then I'm a rap. I'm like, what? Let me hear something. And I hear this real. I'm like, oh, all right. Ain't the greatest, but it's gonna work. For damn sure. He's jacking these other weirdos. So, boom. Bro came home and he put on. He kept putting on to the point where sometimes he went back hurting and got it back up. Kept pointing on, kept stashing, kept moving militant. And then when I came home, bro had me set to a bro where, like, he had self-set. I'm like, people might think that's small. That's big. I mean, even if it was a dollar, he thought about me.
What?
He had me in mind. What's trying to keep me? Like, that's discipline. That's special. That's genuine love. I'm my little baby boy. You know what I mean? Yeah. I told him, you know what I'm saying?
You did good, Rowdy, because he definitely held it down, man. Like, he definitely held it down. And can't nobody say nothing about Fetty, man. He held the whole squad down, the fam down. You talk about he was barely rapping, and then he parlayed that into a deal with Def Jam and you know, did it big, you know what I'm saying? Did it real big.
And that project wasn't bad.
Right.
It really wasn't. It really wasn't what it was. It needed more, I say like this, it needed more creativity in the booth, more swag to it, more funness. Because a lot of tracks are rehearsed to me. You know, I keep everything tall. Mm-hmm. Even with me, I criticize myself sometimes. Nobody perfect for me. When I feel like I could do better, criticize myself.
Word.
Then I'm going in and I'm going to what I criticize. That's just me, for me.
Listen,
I just animal with me.
Word. Hey, bro, you big bro, too. So, of course, you're going to you know what I'm saying? You're gonna be hardest on him to make sure he always right. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta keep it real, you know what I mean?
Bro, what I'm gonna tell you right now though, bro got some shit coming. He got his record called Simple. And he got a record, mark my words, I'm telling you right here right now, he got a record called Simple.
Crazy.
And he got a record called Posted. Damn, ain't got nothing like he just did with Schmandog, the other artist I told you about. Yo, Fetty. He sleep?
Oh, shit.
He got some more shit. They don't act bad. On these sides, nigga, we going bad. Oh, my God. That's where my mom was looking. Don't play tough. Gosh, man.
So what can we expect in the near future from Rowdy Rebel? What you got cooking up?
I said I got some much music. Bro, home. I want to get bro on my project, of course. So I'm waiting to get bro on a couple of songs and then have a couple more sit downs with the bros and label and see what new record we're going to push because it's mad songs out there, like I said. And right now, it's three of them that's the top three, and we just all decided. So.
Yeah. So I got one more for you. We have a lot of artists on the call too. A lot of them are from the DMV area, DC, Maryland, Virginia, and Baltimore City. If they wanted to get in touch with you or your camp to get a feature, like, what's the process? Who they gotta holler at?
So right now with features, I ain't really doing too much features because label's not even really clearing the features right now. You see? So like, I'll be lying if I say. Not me lying, not really, like, cause I'll do the feature, like, I'll take your bride, I'll do the track, but it ain't up to me to play this shit now, for me, I'm on a contract, for me, so, I'm able to play this shit, for me, so, if you want to do a feature, you're going to have to send a song to Dom going to have to let me hear the song, then I'm like, all right, if it's fire or not. Then I'm gonna send it to Epic and see. Can we clear this because they want to do a feature with me. But more time to the 10, Epic is trying to hit this. Ain't trying to hit that shit right now.
And plus, we tell artists all the time too. You gotta just get out here and network and build some type of relationship with other artists too. You know what I'm saying? Like just jumping in DMs or trying to. Book a feature through, management. The artist don't know you. Even if the song is fire, the energy ain't just always gonna be there. So the real key is just to get out there. Shit, book Rowdy for a show. You know what I'm saying? Get him to the city. Book him for a show. Build that relationship up. You know what I'm saying? And then things can go a different way. You know what I mean? Rowdy can make that call.
The rest
of clear this. The priority right now is Jesse Owens, Rowdy Rebel featuring Nav, all the DJs on the line. If you don't got it, me and Reds will make sure you do have it. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to take no more of your time.
Right now. Hey, yo, who don't got the track?
Yeah, if you don't got the track, speak.
If you don't got it, say something in the chat. We send it.
No, we got it. We got it, and we playing it. I'm talking about.
I'm more niggas. Hells. Who got the track? Yo, Joe, who the fuck got the track?
Everybody got it.
Yo, Joe, what the fuck is going over there?
Somebody who don't got Apple Music and Spotify.
Yo, Joe, what's up, baby?
What's up, brother?
What up?
Thank you guys so much for your time, and like I said, Roddy's a hard worker. Listen, man, he can tell you.
I just did this track with G Herbo yesterday, too.
Yeah, so this kid, this is real, guys. Like, this is what we waited for. This is what we all wanted. We got it now. Let's support, please. And he's going to keep working his ass off. He's tired. Don't get twisted, but he's ready for this.
Yeah, I'm tired, but look how.
Yeah.
Hold on,
man.
Hold on, Wilder.
Yeah. We appreciate
you. I'm here. What are you doing right now? Look.
Hey. Okay.
How about this?
see what that.
You over there? I'm about to get crazy.
It's Taco Mondays over there. Taco Mondays.
I'm about to get crazy. Hold on, look. Don't play
with me. I ain't no Brooklyn niggas cook in the 90s.
Oh, yeah, that's what 6 years up north for Dutel, nigga.
Got this trap.
Niggas, white rice in there. I can't touch that right now, though. You feel me? Let that thing simmer.
Huh? Hey. get the invite. Next time, we got to do the interview from the crib.
Oh, from the crib, niggas, come on now. that's the way a nigga don't invite a nigga over, right? That's your mama. that's a nice way of saying, nigga, you can't come over here.
No doubt.
Not yet. We ain't there yet, man. We just built it.
It's cool. He gonna show us that, tease us, and then say, man, fuck y'all for real. Y'all can't.
Nah, I'm missing the meal prep.
No, it's okay. It's all right.
I'm cool, man.
I appreciate you guys' time. It means a lot. You know, and please
support us. I'm about to get ready for my baby girl to come home. She just came back from St. Thomas. About to finish cooking this nice, beautiful dinner. I got the roses in the bedroom. I'm sure what I'm doing too. Look, I really give my man. I'm really a different breed, man. There's no man like me, man. And like, I'm the perfect cousin. I got to go for baby girl. I ain't like the candles yet because I don't know what she got, but this is what I got. Oh shit, I'm cooking candles and shit.
You going?
Fucking with y'all, man. Fucking with y'all, I'm cooking candles and shit, man.
Good night, man. You go ahead.
Hey, every day is Valentine's Day.
We're gonna keep supporting.
Yeah, every day I put on for my bed.
Every day is Valentine's Day when you're fucking with Rowdy. That's what it is, man. Yeah. PS9 in the building. Rowdy Rebel. Make sure y'all drop that. Jesse Owens and all the mixes. You know what I'm saying? We on the lookout for what's
going on. Y'all want that,
man, one love, Rowdy. We got y'all back, man. Stu Review Mafia. That's what it is, man. Thank you, June. I know if June already tapped off. Thank you, everybody that tapped in. That's another edition of the Stew Review featuring Rowdy Rebel. You know what I'm saying? Y'all got to look into, you know, what's going on with him. Coming from the source himself, you know what I'm saying? Feel his energy, feel his mold, feel his passion. You know what I'm saying? And y'all see that it's real. You know what I mean? It ain't no fake bullshit going on over there. So we like to support.
Oh, he ain't no better chef than me.
Come on, Reds, you got what you got, Reds. You ain't showed us nothing yet. He showed us something. What you got? You ain't showed us nothing. What?
Shit, hold on, gun clapper.
Hold on,
gun clapper.
Red, you cooking every joint.
You know I do, and I made that myself. I just put it in the box.
Every joint you cooking, you in the kitchen every time.
You damn right. Tell them, Neff, it ain't no game.
I was just about to say you was in here with us the whole time. How you was cooking?
Huh?
You was in here with us.
Oh, no. The
time. How you was cooking?
I ordered that. Philly's finest. Philly's finest. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But no, this was fun. And DJs, if you need the record, get at me. Yeah, and that's what we doing. DJ Flo on here. What's up, Flo? This nigga sound just like Rowdy Rebel. Watch this.
Yo, stop it.
Don't
he? Yo, cut it out. Cut it out. What's going on, bro?
See, he sound just like that nigga. All them New York niggas sound like that.
Yo, stop it, bro. Stop it.
It's funny.
It's a Brooklyn thing. You know, every borough got its own little twist to it. That's a Brooklyn twang.
Mm-hmm. No, it's all good. This was fun. We got Victory on here, my man Marcus G. Lord, DJ Nitro.
It's PStew. What's up, everybody?
What up, what up? Mm-hmm. I'm trying to get a stronger connection or something when it's a lot of people in the room and sometimes the connection get crazy and you get that weird delay in his answers. Did everybody hear it or was it just me?
Hear what? I
think it was just you.
No.
Ball going up and down.
On my end as well.
It's clear though. Mm-hmm.
All right, good shit, good shit.
That's just
doubling
down. Disturbing.
That's what's up. We definitely going when we do the Stew Review live concert, we trying to get Rowdy as a headliner, along with a lot of the artists that are featured on the Indie Artist Spotlight. So be on the lookout for that. Also, for all the artists, you know, here, Red,
we can't hear you, Steve, because somebody mic is over yours.
Hold on. That's your shit, man.
It's better now.
Hello? Yeah, you good now.
Now I'm saying, me and DJ Reddz, and Super and the whole family, we coming with this consulting firm, man. We about to go nationwide, global with it, breaking artists, putting podcasts together, content, movements. You know what I'm saying? Not just like, yo, send an e-blast out, but really putting plays together and putting shit together for artists to make sure artists got all the tools that they need to really survive out here and make strides and make progress out here and not just keep running around in circles. You know what I'm saying? So be on the lookout for that, too. That's coming real soon.
Yes, indeed. And we're going to have another indie spotlight in a couple weeks, so. If you're trying to get down, you already know. A lot of y'all been a part of it. And just reach out. We got you. Okay, Nitro moving around the crib. Showing that nigga Rowdy Rebel. He ain't the only one out here.
I say we put Tiago at least on the indie spotlight.
Oh.
Y'all trying to get me to log off early? Just say that.
That was 2 weeks in a row, too.
I was about to say, we know that's 2 weeks in a row. I thought we was going to get out of here without bringing the Tara Lanise bars up. But now that you've brought it up.
Oh, hold on.
What you got for it, Red?
Hold up, man.
Yeah. There you go.
She out of here. Come on, now.
Yeah. That is hilarious.
She was like, gone.
No. Ow. Indeed. This was fun. I gotta clean up. We got some good guests over the next couple weeks, so keep it locked in. And that's how we rock it. Prince Victory in the grocery store getting it in.
Walmart. You already know. You know what I'm saying? We gotta be able to multitask while we listen to the good info. Feel me?
Indeed.
If y'all ever be having questions and stuff, just put it in the chat. And we'll try and get to it. I try to open up the floor for the DJs sometimes, but, you know, whatever. But if y'all got questions, just throw them in the chats and we'll start getting to them so we can get to them and get as much information out of these artists and DJs and record label execs and we can. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, indeed. Yeah, don't be shy, y'all. Shit. We had these people on here. So y'all can ask them whatever the fuck y'all want. Just ask.
Oh, I didn't know we could do that.
You know I'll be ready, baby. Yeah, that's why. Nah. All y'all gotta do is just put it in the comments, and then we gonna pull y'all up so y'all can ask them. We ain't super bougie in this community. We doing what we do.
I saw your question kind of late, Bob. I was gonna get to it, but next time definitely. Keep the questions coming. We'll get to them all. We'll do a whole little segment of just opening the floor for questions and do it like that. You know what I'm saying?
Most definitely. Most definitely. Appreciate y'all, though.
Mm-hmm. Season 3 of the DJ Reddz Show coming soon. Marcus G. Lorick on here. Talk to him, Marcus. You over there looking like you worth a million.
I'm just chilling. I'm just taking in everything. That's it. Mm-hmm. Just getting ready.
Shit. I'll see.
Set up.
little something.
Well, looking good. I want to see the reel in the back. I don't know about the reel. That's that old school.
That's that nostalgia.
That's that splice.
Oh, yeah. You gotta have
know about that splice gang. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Got to splice it on the angle.
Stuff. I got some old stuff from the NAACP. Like, I got some historic shit on there.
You over there? You drinking, Marcus? What you doing?
Oh, yeah. I got some Basil Hayden. Basil Hayden.
That's rich nigga shit. We don't know nothing about that.
What is that? That's a whiskey? At all.
Yeah, it's a whiskey.
I figured that. That name like that, that sounded like a whiskey.
Yeah, check it out. It's pretty good. It's smooth, so, you know.
All right.
But I appreciate y'all getting on here, seeing a couple people.
Yeah.
My man Ray. I ain't seen you in the hot minute, Ray.
Man, you already know I'm down here living. Feel me? I already know what you're doing.
Yeah, Ray down in Atlanta here, old ATL here now.
Oh yeah,
Black Hollywood.
You see, he got it. You see, he grown with braces, and that's Black success right there.
We gonna come down there and fuck with you.
Man, I can't wait.
He getting to the chick.
Cluck cluck.
Hey, motherfucker, cluck cluck. All right, y'all. I'm out of here, man.
All right, y'all.
Later.
See y'all next week. One love.